October 6th, if you missed it. It was over in Hillsborough here at the Civic Center, and they had a bunch of wonderful outdoor activities, lots of Civil War, action memorabilia, things going on, demonstrations. It was a really great day. And then our band kind of wrapped up the whole day by playing our concert at the end. So it was really fun. It was great to get out into the community. We really enjoyed it. And so now I'm ready to share it with you. So the first piece we played was a dedicatory picture by Clifton Williams. And so Clifton Williams, this was not specific to Missouri so much, but Clifton Williams was a winner of the two Oswald Awards, composition awards, from the American Bandmasters Association back in 1956 and 1957 for two of his wind compositions. So this piece, I liked it. It was dedicatory overture, kind of dedicating our concert to Jefferson County. So the next piece we're going to play is a march, National Emblem March. The band is like really, really happy that we're finally playing some marches because they never play marches. So they've been begging me for years, come on, let's play more marches. So I thought, well, this is it. This is a good opportunity to pull out some marches to do some kind of real traditional band music. That's just fun to listen to. So tonight's concert is basically some marches, some melodies that you know, familiar tunes, and then some things that are specific to Missouri. So this is, there's a little piece of the national anthem in this, there's a small quote of the national anthem in this piece, but this was Bagley's very favorite march, and this was a march that was actually considered one of the best marches ever written, according to John Philip Sousa, and according to Fred Fennell, who was the director of the Eastman Wind Ensemble and one of the leaders of the band world. So it's a national emblem march.
Thank you.
familiar to him, hopefully to all of you. The melody actually goes all the way back to England, but this is Variations on Scarborough Fair. And Calvin Custer, the composer, he is a conductor and horn player from Syracuse, New York. The melody of Scarborough Fair is an English ballad actually from the 13th century. But obviously we've heard it many times, right? There's the famous Simon and Garfunkel version of it. When Simon and Garfunkel performed it, actually, it was combined with an anti-war song that Garfunkel had written called The Side of a Hill as well. So, Variations on Scarborough.
Thank you.
Patrol. This is dating, this is our oldest piece, 1891. This was written by Meacham. He was actually mostly known for his composition of ballads, but this particular piece uses a combination of a bunch of different melodies. So you hear the tune Columbia, Gem of the Ocean, which you don't recognize the title, you'll recognize the melody. Dixie, which you all know, Yankee Doodle. Dixie actually originated in the 1850s. It was from the minstrel shows of the period. And then it later became the national anthem for the Confederate Army. Yankee Doodle goes back to, all the way back to 15th century Europe. But the words, of course, are from the American Revolutionary War. And while I was researching some of this, like Jefferson County, Missouri history a little bit, I found, of course, a lot of information about the Civil War. There was actually only one major battle that actually happened here in Missouri. But I learned that Missouri was actually the third most fought over state in the Civil War. That 42% of all battles in Missouri during the first year of the, or 42% of all battles happened in Missouri during the first year of the Civil War in 1861. Missouri, of course, was a border state, so we actually sent troops and supplies to both the North and the South. There was a star on both the Union and the Confederate flag for Missouri. We had a total of 110,000 soldiers who served the Union and 30,000 soldiers who served in the Confederacy. And then, like I said, the one main battle that happened in Missouri was the Battle of Blackwell in 1861. this next piece is called Missouri Shindig.
It's a piece,
it's a more contemporary piece than many of these, written in 1997 by Owen Reed, but it is based on a very old fiddle tune. So Owen Reed is actually from Missouri, grew up in Odessa, Missouri, and this whole song is based on a square dance fiddle tune called Give the Fiddler a Dram. Owen Reed actually was really a big fan of jazz. He studied jazz, learned jazz, a lot of jazz influence. He lived in Kansas City for a while. He ended up being a teacher of composition at Michigan State and ended up being the author of 10 books on composition, so a very significant composer. But his father was a fiddler, so he grew up hearing this tune. And I found a little clip of the actual fiddle tune, so I'm going to have Joel play you a little bit of Give the Fiddler a Dram.
Thank you.
Symphony with one of the ensembles, one of the college ensembles, and he's just like this really amazing person, and he just is kind and open and very approachable, and really just writes some sometimes amazingly complex music, as well as really, really beautiful music. So I hope you enjoy this.
Thank you.
on the evening by Mark Williams.
I
To honor our men and women of service. So I would like any of you members of the audience to please stand when we announce your branch of the military. I'll announce them as we get through each song. I would also love to announce, and I wrote it down but I forgot, we have several members of our band that I would like to also honor since they can't stand while they're playing. We have Steve Hoy on the trombone in the Army, right? Bob Francis on trombone, also who's in the Marines. And we have back in the percussion, Kendra Berg was in the
Army and Air Force.
Kendra Berg. That's everybody. So please stand so that we can honor you during this song.
Thank you.
fun to be here. It's really fun to make music with this wonderful group of people. I'm always glad that I get to do this every year, every fall. Every year I get to pick out new music, and I love it. It's really fun. So thanks for coming and listening. Our last piece is Bullets and Bayonets. So this is written by one of the most famous composers of marches, John Philip Sousa. He was a conductor, actually, of the Marine Band back in 1880, when he was 26 years old, got that job, so pretty significant. In 1892, he formed his own band, and for 40 years, he had the Sousa Band. He composed over 200 works, not just marches, also symphonic poems, and suites, and operettas. When he traveled with his band, he went to Europe, and he actually introduced ragtime music to Europe back in 1900. So that influenced actually several European composers. This particular march, Bullets and Bayonets, is dedicated to the men and women of the U.S. Infantry of World War I. Again, thanks for coming.